What's up, guys? It's Destructor Gaming Channel here, and got yourselves another video. It's a Burnout Paradise review, and let's get into this. So what is the gameplay of Burnout Paradise? It's a racing game, basically, but unlike other racing games, this is actually an open world one. There's like a huge open world environment, and you can just kind of go at your own pace, really. That's pretty much like the gist of the gameplay, really, you know. And the other thing that helps the game set and like stand out is, of course, the destructible environments to the cars. At least, you know, it's very destructible in the cars. You can really send cars fucking flying when you're actually doing the actual game. So that's pretty much like the whole gist of the usual Burnout series stick. But that's kind of what makes this game stand out in a nutshell. So what is it that you can do in Burnout Paradise exactly? Well, there's four things, and they're all highlighted in colors. Blue, yellow, green, and red. Blue is, of course, your standard racing. You pretty much go from one area to the next. Usually, it's pretty long. Like, you can start from, like, say, the beach, and it goes all the way to the mountains, because the races like to be long like that, and it definitely makes it very intense and engaging. You have, of course, road rage, which is in color in red, and basically, you basically just have to just eliminate as much cars as possible. There's, like, a certain threshold it wants you to have to eliminate, so like usually be like say something like 10 cars or something. That's pretty much like road rage, and that's my personal favorite because I just love bullying other cars into oblivion. It's really fun. You can keep going as much as you want until the time runs out, but generally you have to have a certain threshold, and it's so much fun. Yellow is of course marked man, and this time you have to avoid your car getting crashed by a bunch of other cars that are gonna come looking to kill you, and trust me, they will kill you. They are pretty brutal. They are not forgiving. If you just, like, slow down, they will just come and, like, boom! And you just go crashing. You better be on your toes at all costs, alright? And you better hope to God you can find, you know, repair stations so you can drive your car through so you can, not die, basically. Because, holy shit. And the gist of it is you have to just, go from, like, one point to the other. Similar to, of course, racing, of course. But said you have to just be avoid dying, basically. And green is basically stunt, which is basically just, you gotta do like a bunch of stunts to get like certain points. It can be ranging from, well, you know, how much airtime you have, drifting, you know, crashing through like billboards, that type of stuff, really. There's a time limit to it, but yeah, that's pretty much it. As much combo as you can get, that's what it is. That's pretty much the four things to do in Burnout Paradise, and they all bring something different to the table, really. My personal favorite's Marked Man and Road Rage, because those are just the most chaotic, and they just make show the game off at their absolute best. But that's just my opinion, of course. Now, let's talk about the cars and the looks of it, like, just the looks in general, the cars. In terms of cars, there's three types of cars. Speed, stunt, and aggression. Which, you know, depending on what it is, it can be more useful to use those certain cars for those certain events that I mentioned earlier. Speed cars are the fastest of the bunch, but they're also the weakest and are easily, like, you know, be able to crash. You basically will die using them a lot, you know, unless you're really fast and know how to use, like, drifting and pretty much have good driving skills. Stunt cars are a little bit slower, but they're a bit more durable, and they're usually good for pretty much when you do, like, a big-ass jump, really. That's all they're really good for, and they have the best boost. Aggression cars are the slowest, but they're also the most durable of the bunch, and they'll take more of a beating compared to the other cars. Those are my personal favorite to use because, you know, I'll get into a little later, but still, that's pretty much, like, the whole gist of, like, the cars, really. You can still, like, go do, like, you know, road rage with speed cars, but it'd be a lot more difficult if you do that, so have fun. Overall, the looks, I mean, the game, graphically, I mean, I know it's a remaster that you're seeing, but, like, I can tell, like, for it's a nice little remastered graphics, and looking at the graphics from the original, it looked good for 2008. It was a solid-looking game. Not really much to say. The environments are very detailed, and you know, it really does feel like you're in, like, Los Angeles. I know it's not set in Los Angeles, but I definitely get, a sense of, like, this feels like Los Angeles meets Denver, because the area is big, because if you go more in the city area, it feels like you're in, like, California or some shit, like, you know, New York, more like California, just like the sunny, like, beach look to it, and just pretty much like, yeah, you get to drive around and just have so much fun. And then when you go up more the mountain areas, it feels like you're in Denver, which I think is what the developers intended for, really, truth be told. And it's pretty good. It's really good, I must say. The area is big. There's a lot of exploration to do, a lot of, like, exploring around, little, like, pathways you can take, and it just feels so alive. I mean, it just feels like, wow, this feels like a real city area to be in. And so, like, the developers did a great job on it. Now, the soundtrack, because this game has quite the rocking soundtrack. It is a solid soundtrack. It's not perfect. I mean, you have Avril Lavigne's Girlfriend. What the fuck? And Depeche Mode is in here, and I'm like, L. Those are L's. But overall, the soundtrack is really rocking. You can just turn off the songs you don't want to hear at all. Thank God. But the soundtrack does have, of course, Guns N' Roses, which you hear as soon as you start up the game. And, of course, has, like, Alice in Chains, Soundgarden, Killswitch Engage, and Faith No More. And much more surprises and turns, because the soundtrack really ranges from, like, the 90s to the 2000s, really, for the most part. Except for Faith No More and Guns N' Roses. Those are the only 80s songs in there. But it definitely has that mix, and it's a solid soundtrack that really gets your blood pumping, and it really does fit the overall mood and atmosphere of the game, really. And it's just really fun to hear. Like, when you hear, like, all the good music coming from the game, it's like, oh yeah, this definitely makes the game feel more alive. Now, the game isn't exactly perfect. It does have some problems. Two main problems for me. Number one, okay, as much as it's fun to crash cars and just go insane, especially, like, you know, when you're actually, like, just bullying other cars, it is so easy to do it. I find it's way too easy. Now, apparently, it was, like, more difficult from, like, the previous games, like, Revenge and stuff, like, and you actually had to, like, crash other cars. But, so, I find it's a little too easy here, and it's also way too easy for you to just crash into shit. Like, you can just be driving along, doing whatever, and then you don't even, like, go full speed, and you can just lightly touch a car, and you can just start going flying, like, boom! And it's like, oh my god. It gets really annoying, especially when you're in tight races, when you're trying to, like, make sure you win, and then that shit happens. Like, fucking bullshit. And speaking of races, this is what I find really annoying. When you're racing through the game, and when you fail, instead of, like, loading back to, like, you know, try it again, you don't get that option. You pretty much just have to go all the way back to the event that you want to do, and have to do this shit all over again. And especially with how big the game is, it really can get really annoying after a while. It's like, I just want to just get this over with, fuck. And it just wastes your time. It doesn't give you an option to reset when you screw up. And if you want to decide to load, it's not going to load to, like, you know, the particular checkpoint that you were at. No, it's just loading you in the fucking garage. And it just gets on your fucking nerves after a while. It was, like, the two problems with the game overall. But if I had to give this game a rating, honestly, the game gets, like, an 8.8 out of 10. It is a really fun game. I strongly recommend it. There's also multiplayer in this game, but truth be told, it's just basically, like, you know, open world shit. You can just kind of do whatever the fuck you want. There isn't really much to say about multiplayer, so it ain't worth talking about. But generally, the game is really fun. I recommend playing it. You know, there's definitely a lot of hours you can spend doing it, and really, you'll find a little more extra content when you're done playing with, like, you know, the main core of the game that you can complete it. But that's been the Destructor Gaming Channel for you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Take care, and of course, God bless you all.